Hello friends, today we are going to see the MCQ of pile foundation. So first question, the art of driving piles into the ground was first established by option A, Greeks, option B, Romans, option C, Philippines, option D, none of mention. So the correct answer is option B, Romans. So next question, based on the functions, the pile can be classified into dash types. Option A, 4, option B, 6, option C, 8, option D, 3. So the correct answer is option C, 8. So next question, which of the following piles is used to compact looser granular soil? Option A, friction piles, option B, end bearing piles, option C, compaction piles, option D, tensile piles. So the correct answer is option C, compaction piles. So next question, the piles that are used for protecting structures from ships and floating object is option A, anchor piles, option B, fender piles, option C, compaction piles, option D, batter piles. So the correct answer is option B, fender piles. So next question, the modern pile driving method was first invented by option A, Romans, option B, Nasmyth, option C, Terzaghi, option D, Vitruvius. So the correct answer is option B, Nasmyth. So next question, the precast concrete piles are generally used for the maximum design load of a boat. Option A, 50 tons, option B, 100 tons, option C, 75 tons, option D, 80 tons. So the correct answer is option D, 80 tons. So next question, cast inside piles may be classified into dash classes. So option A, 3 classes, option B, 8, option C, 2, option D, 4. So the correct answer is option C, 2. So next question, composite piles are suitable for option A, maximum design load, option B, the project above the water table, option C, compacting the soil, option D, protect waterfront structures. So the correct answer is option B, the project above the water table. So next question, piles are commonly driven into the ground by means of special device called option A, pile driver and hammer, option B, driller, option C, none of mention, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, pile driver and a hammer. So next question, which of the following piles is cast inside piles type of concrete piles? So option A, under-rimmed piles, option B, Riemann standard piles, option C, anchor piles, option D, pressure piles. So the correct answer is option B, Riemann standard pile. So next question, the type of hammer used for driving piles is option A, drop hammer, option B, diesel hammer, option C, vibratory hammer, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option D, all of mention. So next question, if the hammer is raised by steam and allowed to fall by gravity on the top of the pile is called option A, diesel hammer, option B, vibratory hammer, option C, single acting hammer, option D, drop hammer. So the correct answer is option C, single acting hammer. So next question, the maximum load which can be carried by a pile is defined as its option A, ultimate load carrying capacity, option B, ultimate bearing resistance, option C, ultimate bearing capacity, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option D, all of mention. So next question, the allowable load which the pile can carry safely is determined on the basis of option A, factor of safety, option B, load test, option C, stability of pile foundation, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option C, stability of pile foundation. So next question, the load carrying capacity of pile can be determined by which of the following methods? Option A, dynamic formula, option B, static formula, option C, pile load test, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option D, all of mention. So next question, which of the following is sum of commonly used dynamic formula? Option A, engineering use formula and Hayley's formula, option B, static formula, option C, none of mention, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, engineering use formula and Hayley's formula. So next question, when the pile hammer hits the pile, the total driving energy is equal to option A, weight of hammer times the height of the drop, option B, weight of the ramming time times the height of the stroke, option C, sum of impact of the ram, option D, sum of impact of the ram plus the energy delivered by the explosion. So the correct answer is option A, weight of hammer times the height of drop. So next question, dynamic formula are the best suited for dash type of soil. Option A, fine grain soil, option B, coarse grain soil, option C, cohesive soil, option D, none of mention. So the correct answer is option B, coarse grain soil. So next question, dynamic formula does not indicate about option A, temporary changes in soil structure and future settlement, option B, allowable load, option C, none of mention, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, temporary changes in the soil structure and future settlement. So next question, the dynamic formula is the value for which of the following type of soil? Option A, loose sand, option B, saturated soil, option C, clay soil, option D, compacted soil. So the correct answer is option C, clay soil. So next question, in dynamic formula, what are the energy losses that are not accounted? Option A, energy losses due to vibration and energy losses due to heat, option B, frictional losses, option C, none of mention, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, energy losses due to vibration and energy losses due to heat. So next question, the greater operation to any of the pile driving formula is option A, uncertainty in the relation between dynamic and static resistance, option B, shear strength of the soil, option C, uncertainty in the allowable pressure, option D, none of mention. So the correct answer is option A, uncertainty in the relation between dynamic and static resistance. So next question, the static formula is based on the assumption that the ultimate bearing capacity QUP is equal to option A, RF plus QA, option B, RF plus RP, option C, AS plus AP, option D, QUP divided by F. So the correct answer is option B, RF plus RP. So next question, the pile load test should be performed on option A, working pile, option B, test pile, option C, all of mention, option D, none of mention. So the correct answer is option C, all of mention. So next question, the factor of safety that should be adopted for finding the allowable load for the pile is option A, 2.5 and 3, option B, 4. So the correct answer is option A, 2.5 and 3. So next question, for pile in cohesive soil, dash is neglected for the individual pile action. Option A, frictional resistance, option B, the surface area of the pile, option C, shear strength of soil, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option B, the surface area of the pile. So next question, the allowable load for the pile is given by dash equation. Option A, QA equal to QUP divided by F, option B, QA equal to QUP into F, option C, QA equal to WH divided by F into S plus C, option D, QA equal to WH divided by 6 into S plus 2.5. So the correct answer is option A, QA equal to QP divided by F. So next question, the test which can be used for separating load carried by the pile is option A, cyclic load test, option B, pile load test, option C, penetration test, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, cyclic load test. So next question, the efficiency of the pile group depends upon option A, characteristics of pile and spacing of piles, option B, bearing capacity of pile. So the correct answer is option A, characteristics of pile and spacing of pile. So next question, which of the following formula can be used for determining the efficiency of the pile group? Option A, dynamic formula, option B, static formula, option C, Hayley's formula, option C, Feld's formula, option D, Hayley's formula. So the correct answer is option C, Feld's formula. So next question, in which of the following rule the value of each pile is reduced by 1/16th? Option A, Converse-Labra formula, option B, Feld formula, option C, Saylor-Kinney formula, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option B, Fell's formula. So next question, the bearing capacity of single pile in clay is mainly due to option A, friction, option B, shear strength of soil, option C, allowable load, option D, ultimate load. So the correct answer is option A, friction. So next question, the downward drag action on the pile due to the movement of surrounding is called option A, skin friction, option B, negative skin friction, option C, frictional force. So the correct answer is option B, negative skin friction. So next question, the area of the pile group along the failure surface is equal to option A, perimeter into area of cross section, option B, breadth into length, option C, perimeter into length, option D, perimeter divided by area of cross section. So the correct answer is option C, perimeter into length. So next question, the pile spacing of each pile is taken as the dash of the diameter. Option A, 4, option B, 5, option C, 3, option D, 10. So the correct answer is option C, 3. So next question, the settlement of pile group of friction piles can be computed on the assumption that option A, clay is incompressible, option B, pile below the lower level is ignored, option C, bearing resistance is zero, option D, none of mention. So the correct answer is option A, clay is incompressible. So next question, as a rough approximation, the settlement of group of friction piles can be computed on the assumptions that the clay contained between the top of piles is incompressible. Option A, QUP equal to RF plus RP. B, option B, QUG is equal to N into QB into neta G. Option C, QUG is equal to N into QP divided by neta G. Option D, none of mention. So the correct answer is option B, QUG equal to N into QUP into neta G. So next question, when the underreamed piles has only the one bulb, it is called option A, multi underreamed piles, option B, single underreamed piles, option C, unique underreamed piles, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option B, single underreamed piles. So next question, the diameter of the underreamed piles is kept equal to dash times the diameter of the pile stem. Option A, 4, option B, 5, option C, 2.5, option D, 2. So the correct answer is option C, 2.5. So next question, underreamed piles foundation is most suitable for dash type of condition. Option A, seasoned moisture change. Option A, seasonal moisture change. Option B, dry conditioned soil. Option C, cohesive type of soil. Option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, seasonal moisture change. So next question, the load carrying capacity of underreamed piles may be determined by option A, safe load test, option B, penetration test, option C, pile load test, option D, cyclic load test. So the correct answer is option A, safe load test. So next question, the underreamed piles are connected by the beam is known as option A, capping beam and grade beam, option B, reamed beam, option C, none of mention, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option A, capping beam or grade beam. So next question, the maximum spacing of underreamed piles should not normally exceed option A, 2 meter, option B, 2.5 meter, option C, 1.5 meter, option D, 30 centimeters. So the correct answer is option B, 2.5 meters. So next question, underreamed piles are normally bored dash piles. Option A, cast inside piles, option B, precast piles, option C, steel piles, option D, composite piles. So the correct answer is option A, cast inside piles. So next question, the spacing of the piles in underreamed pile foundation depends upon which of the following factor. Option A, nature of the ground and type of pile, option B, load acting on the pile, option C, none of mention, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is nature of the ground and the type of soil. So next question, the equipment required for construction of underreamed piles is option A, auger boring guide, option B, spherical auger, option C, concreting funnel, option D, all of mention. So the correct answer is option D, all of mention. So next question, the use of bore guide in underreamed piles foundation is essential for option A, drill the borehole, option B, to provide the support of the pile, option C, to keep the boreholes vertical, option D, to set the guide assembly in the position. So the correct answer is option C, to keep the borehole vertical. So next question, the dimension of the bulb in the under-rimmed piles can be checked by option A, meter scale, option B, GI pipe assembly, option C, auger, option D, under-rimmer. So the correct answer is option B, GI pipe assembly. So next question, the pile group in under-rimmed piles foundation can be tested by means of option A, freestanding piles and pile foundation, option B, cannot be tested. So the correct answer is option A, freestanding piles and pile foundation. So next question, for completion of one under rim, how many buckets of earth required to removal? Option A, 5, option B, 10, option C, 8, option D, 3. So the correct answer is option C, 8. So next question, enlarging the stem of borehole at the depth is done by using option A, spherical auger, option B, under-rimmer, option C, boring guide. So the correct answer is option B, under-rimmer. So next question, the equipment required for construction of under-rimmed piles is option A, auger boring guide, option B, spherical auger, option C, concreting funnel, option D, all of mentioned. So the correct answer is option D, all of mentioned. So next question, in the process of pile foundation, boring is done with the help of option A, boring guide, option B, under-rimmer, option C, spiral auger, option C, pile beams. So the correct answer is option C, spiral auger. So again, we will see you next video. Thank you.